At the edge of a great forest was a modest little inn. The innkeeper had a kind and beautiful young daughter named Kyo. Kyo had been taught ever since she was a tiny little girl to think nothing of herself, but always of the welfare of others. So she cooked and scrubbed, working hard every day to bring happiness to those around her. Every night, after serving a visitor supper, Kyo would say, "I hope my humble efforts have pleased you." And the visitor would invariably respond,
"Hai, domo, thank you."
And she would say, "Your happiness is my happiness." Kyo was at that moment in life when a girl becomes a woman. Her plump, ripe body was in the spring of life. Her red lips pouting soft and full. Her brown eyes filled with yearning. Some nights when work was particularly tiring, she would fall into the deep slumber of exhaustion and dream her dream of a handsome young man. With deep, fathomless eyes. And she would say to him, "I hope my humble efforts have pleased you." And he would say to her,
"I do."
She could say, "Yeah." He would take a step towards her and encircle her in his arms. And his arms were brown and powerful. And they held her tight all night long until they became one. And this was her dream. So it was that one day, Anchen, a monk from Dojoji, on a pilgrimage from shrine to shrine, stumbled out of the forest near the inn. The innkeeper, seeing the monk with his begging bowl, invited him to stay and eat. Now Anchen just happened to be a handsome young man with deep, fathomless eyes. And Anchen had been taught ever since he was a tiny little boy to think nothing of others, but only of the welfare of himself. So it was that night, as Q was serving Anchen's supper, she was drawn into those deep, fathomless eyes. The poor young man, how sad he looks. I must make him happy. So she sang her song and danced her dance. Na na suni na rukonga ita ike na koto yuta. Anchen arose from the table. Thank you. And she looked into those deep, fathomless eyes. Your happiness is my happiness. That night, Q slipped into the deep slumber of exhaustion and dreamed her dream of her handsome young man with his deep, fathomless eyes. And he embraced her in his arms, and his arms were brown and powerful, and they held her tight all night long until they became one. Ah! But it wasn't a dream. Anchen? Anchen? Hi, Momo. Thank you. And he slipped like a shadow into the night. The next morning, Kyo slipped on her loveliest purple silk kimono, a gift from her father on her 16th birthday. She wrapped a black and silver obi around and around and around her slender waist. The room was empty, Anchen gone. The poor young man, unable to pay my dowry, he must have left in great embarrassment. I must go and tell him he's welcome always. So Kyo slipped on her 7-inch platform getup. Setting out on the path after Anchen, Kyo, what a lovely sight. Catching up to him, she said, Anchen, oh Anchen, please, don't be ashamed of your begging bowl. Come back to the inn. Renew your strength. Your happiness is my happiness. And he seemed to take a step towards her. Kyo remembered the night. The blood rushed to her face, but instead of taking her in his arms, he turned abruptly and continued down the path. Wait, Anchen, where are you going? Anchen, wait for me! Mile after mile, she followed. Branches tore her silken gowns, her hair ornaments, those platforms! Woo! up, Anshin was standing over her. His eyes seemed full of worry and concern. Oh, Anshin! My Anshin! Don't worry about me. Now that we're together, I feel no pain.
I've taken a vow of celibacy. Go back to your father where you belong. You threatened my purity.
But what about last night?
It was a dream.
Oh, yes, yes, a dream.
Pretend it never happened.
No!
Let go.
Who will have me now? No!
Let go!
No! Let go! He loves me. He does. It's just that he has a hard time expressing it. Holding back such passion could drive him mad. With the image of Anshin burning in her mind, she climbed up out of the ravine. Branches tore her face and grabbed her hair, and she fainted. For the first time, she heard the sound of the cicadas. Ah, she felt the wind sighing through the pines. And then she looked and saw that her kimono, the gift from her father, was in tatters. And then she looked and saw Anshin. Without thinking, she ran after him. Thank you. Her purple robe slung over it. Her purple robes glittered with a thousand golden scales. Long flames burst from her lips. Her tender legs closed forever and became the long, sinuous tail of a magnificent serpent. She wound and coiled herself about the bell of Dojoji. Black.